Jonathan? Who's Joe?
Hey everybody, it's Jonathan Senor Smoke from the Ring of Fire in Westchester County. I bid you welcome. It's March 13th, 2020. Wow, what a tumultuous week. Just everything's kind of turned upside down, but we will persevere. This will pass. And I'm hoping sooner rather than later. I'm here next to Old Faithful, the Traeger Timberline 850. And what I'm gonna do while we have these periods, this period of shutdown and social distancing, et cetera, is I'm gonna take the time to really go deep with my grilling and my smoking and start experimenting with stuff. And last night, what I did as a start was to kind of test the Timberline, the Traeger Timberline, my 850, because there's just too much stuff written on the web about how your pellet grill can't grill. It's an outdoor oven, and I've said it at times myself. I'm on record on YouTube saying that the only pellet grill that I've had any success grilling with was the Memphis. And what I said to my wife yesterday, I was like, listen, I'm gonna go to A&S Pork Store and visit my buddy Joe here in Yonkers. I'm gonna get the thickest cut of steak that he has, which is a huge, was a big, big ass sirloin. And I've never grilled a sirloin before. My mother has done so at her house, usually does it on the alfresco when it comes out absolutely amazing. So I said, we're gonna do this really simple. I'm gonna get this steak. We're just gonna dress it up with a little bit of olive oil. I'm not gonna do a rub. I'm just gonna hit it with coarse kosher salt and pepper, and then we're gonna let the grill and the smoke do its thing. So what I did was I put it on the middle rack of the Timberline for about 15 minutes, give or take, at about 275 degrees. It might have even been a little bit higher than that. Then what I did was I ratcheted up the grill, took the steak off, turned the grill, it got up to about 450, 475, and I know last night wasn't that cold here in the Northeast, but it got ripping hot pretty quickly. And I put that grill down on the lowest setting you could set a grate on a Timberline. Remember, you have your upper, your middle, and your lower, then you have the searing zone, if you want to call it that. I shouldn't say sear, but it's the absolute lowest position you could set a grate on the Timberline. And that's where the sirloin went. And what I did was I just kept on flipping it every 3 minutes. I did this for about 15 minutes or so, emphasizing that the steak would be, wait, what happened to my lights? There we go. Emphasizing that the steak would be placed more on the back portion of the grill, because that's on the Timberline, that's where a lot of that heat is coming up from. And again, about 15 minutes of this high heat action, and we took it off. I let it sit for about 10 to 15 minutes, let it rest, let it temp with aluminum foil on it, but not wrapped tight. We were tented. And I'm gonna tell you right now, look at the results. If you like medium rare, maybe even a little bit more cooked than that, this was out of this world. And again, it was a simple sirloin steak. I didn't do any of the rubs that we carry at the Ring of Fire. It was salt and pepper. It wasn't even my favorite Jacobson salt. I didn't even use that. I used the that French one with the whale on the cover. I don't even know what the name of it is. But nevertheless, it was so simple to make. It was absolutely phenomenal. Everybody in the household raved about it. My wife did actually make me bring it back and cook it for about 5 more minutes or so, because it was a little bit too rare for her. But for all you carnivores out there who love medium rare, it was completely knocked out of the park. And it was and what I did was the Timberline showed its innate ability to grill. All right, now listen, what's its core competency? It's a smoker, no two ways about that. However, I am never gonna tell somebody that the thing can't grill. If you wanna really take it to the next level, then I definitely would recommend buying the grill grates, throwing them down there. Grill grates that elevate the temperature by about 200, 250 degrees, you'll be in a really good place. And this will be like a Swiss Army knife as a grill. We'll be able to grill, smoke, sear, bake, roast, whatever else you wanna do. But I was very happy with the results. And I go back to this because this grill that I'm using, Old Faithful as I call her, This is the first generation of Timberlines. This is not the D2 technology. D2, I actually just put in my submission, I'm getting a D2 burn unit that I bought. I don't get anything for free. I don't ask anything, you know, for freebies. That's just not the way that we roll. I cannot wait to start playing with the D2 because that's an entirely different plateau than this is. So to those who are planning on doing a lot of cooking over the next few weeks, months, whatever, you're gonna be home, you're gonna be cooking for your kids who are gonna drive you out of your freaking mind. Well, actually, let's just talk about that right now. My kids are off for the next week. My wife's already going stir crazy. If you're thinking that your kids are gonna be home for a couple of weeks, you better be damn sure you're gonna need to find solace going outside to some type of escape pod. Go outside, go to your grill, pick up a Timberline from us, visit us at the Ring of Fire. We sterilize, we sanitize 2 times a day in there. It's spick and span clean. Or very simply, call me up in your pajamas and shop in your pajamas or your underwear if you want, and we'll deliver it to you, no problems, no questions asked. Folks, again, I wish you all the best, be safe, and remember the Timberline 850, the 1300, yes, you can grill on it. Look at the pics, delicious. Thank you from Jonathan here at the Ring of Fire, appreciate it.